Hey guys, so today I'm here with Nick from our ads department, and we're going to be discussing the importance of a website for your brand. Hey Nick.
Hi.
So in today's digital world, we all know that social media is like obviously the top of everyone's mind, but I wanted to just discuss with you about why it's still so important to have like a home base and a really strong website for your brand. So I figured we could just talk a little bit about that and kind of just keep website at the forefront of everyone's mind as they're creating content and promoting their brand. Okay, so Nick, I really want to hear from your perspective why it's so important to still have a really strong website for your brand.
So like you said before, like it's really good to have that home base, and what a lot of brands do, they'll rely so heavily on social media, but they still need a landing page or somewhere where you can send those leads to go to.
Right, makes sense. So the social is great for lead gen, but then it kind of dies off there if you have nowhere to direct them.
Exactly. So that's why it's important to have like a really good website. So it's great to capture the attention on social media, but the real selling is on the website where you can really seal the deal.
Perfect. So can you elaborate a little bit more on that customer journey from capturing their attention on social to kind of, like you said, closing the deal on the website? What does that look like for them and for the company and their own website?
Of course. So whether it's organic or it's paid advertising on your social media platform, the leads will then fill out a form on your social media page. Then it goes directly to your landing page, which would be on your website. And then that has a little bit more questions or a video that may capture them a little bit more.
Really qualify that lead too.
Yeah, pretty much. And then you'll be able to schedule, like book a meeting. For example, our website has a book a meeting link that they'll then click, and that goes into our CRM that then organizes the leads, and then we can schedule a call and actually have some information about them.
Perfect. So the CRM kind of integrates seamlessly with the whole process from social, organic, or paid through to our website and really scheduling.
Yeah. The CRM does most of the heavy lifting, so we're able to have all their information that they put down in the lead form. That gives us more preparation time for the actual call.
Got it. And can you explain a little bit about the importance of a strong website from like an SEO perspective and really ranking among your competition?
Yeah, so from an SEO perspective, like with Google Ads and Google in general, you rank higher based on how good your website is or how optimized it is with Google. Google does a lot of review. So if your keywords are matching what your Google Ads are doing, then you're gonna rank higher in general. You can't rank high just by throwing thousands of dollars into your Google Ads. So what you really have to do is just make sure everything's optimized. Your website has to match your Google Ads in terms of keywords. And then on top of that, Google has to also understand what you're selling and make sure that it's relevant to what you're putting on your words. You can't just throw random words in there to rank higher.
Got it. And also what people are searching to see how you kind of match up. Like the more information you put on your website and the more structured it is, the better you'll rank.
Exactly. And how relevant it is. You can't just chat GPT everything and then expect that Google is going to want to rank you higher.
For sure. Mm-hmm. So we kind of discussed the technical side of the websites, but the aesthetics of it all are just as important, I'm sure, as you know. Just kind of discussing a little bit about what goes into that process and what it looks like when someone works with us for their website, or just the importance of an aesthetically pleasing website as well. Do you notice it makes a difference, especially if you're running some advertisements, if the website is not very visually appealing? Do you notice that kind of cuts off the customer journey there sometimes, or discourages some clients?
Yeah, you want to really make sure your website looks as professional as possible while also grabbing their attention. You don't want just like a bunch of words with like no colors, no even font sizing. Like everything visual really goes into your ads. You can't just throw in like sign up here. It needs to grab their attention further.
Yeah, for sure. And you want it to obviously mimic the identity of your brand as well.
Right? Exactly. You don't want it to just be the same website that someone else could be using. You want it to really stand out and look as professional as possible.
Yeah, for sure. So in terms of the process of creating or working with us to revamp your website or create it from scratch, it is a multi-step process, but we try to make it as seamless as possible with all of our client experiences. So it really starts with a pre-production call and just really learning about the client's business, what they're looking for, what's important to them, just gathering all the necessary information so that we can capture that vision for you and build the website from scratch that way. Or like I said, if it's revamping a website, kind of just understanding their pain points and how, from our perspective as the professionals, what we think can be improved and what they're looking for as well. So from there, we learn a little bit about the brand itself. And we also typically ask for some samples or competitors' websites that you like, just to draw information from. So after we collect all the necessary information, what you're looking for, your logos, branding information, fonts, coloring, all of that, from there, then we take a stab at developing the website for you. So when we're developing the website, we lean on the client to provide the information, kind of like their about me section, the services they provide and the verbiage there. And then we work on really developing the website from there. So putting everything together, kind of putting pen to paper, essentially. So after the initial website is designed, we do offer one round of revisions with all web design clients. So it's really great. We always try to obviously align priorities and understand what they're looking for from the start. But there is always, you know, room for discussion, and we want to make sure that we're providing the clients with what they're looking for, essentially. So we do offer one round of revisions with all web clients. So in terms of launching the website, once we've completed developing it, the whole website is developed on a temporary domain and hosting so that we can make sure it's approved, obviously, before it all gets launched. So once the final website design is approved and ready for launch, we'll need access to the client's hosting and domain in order to do so. And if we don't have access to those things, or you don't have them in the first place, we assist in that process. So the whole process of web development typically takes us 4 to 6 weeks, but there is some back and forth between us and the client, because obviously the client's input is so crucial. We're building this digital hub and home for them and for their brand. So there is some back and forth just to make sure we're really capturing the client's vision and we have everything we need from them in terms of, you know, brand verbiage, everything they offer, their logos and branding guidelines. So once it's all said and done, we typically like to stick to a 4 to 6 week timeline. In comparison to some other companies, it might take them months to do so. So we really pride ourselves on that quick turnaround time and our efficient process. So if you're in the market for a new website and you found this conversation helpful, check out the form on our website to get started.